not having to drive them around.
Yeah, which we've literally been doing for 5 years of his life. So
really, every night, yeah, getting in the car and doing rounders.
Yep.
You know what? I'm not a very good sleeper either. I'm wondering if I could convince Lily
to just try
not be around until, yeah, I softly fall asleep each night. From Stone Mountain, Georgia, and a sleep study facility in Snellville, Georgia.
That's right.
Where Luis gave us a lot to look at.
Oh, wow.
To look at. No, not feeling it. All right. Hey, it was preseason for me, no, too.
I had another one. No, I had a better one. It was a tale of two Arujos. And that would be funny if you were watching the broadcast from home like I was, because we had Araujo, as they kept saying, and Arujo, as they said for the other team. So it was a tale of two Araujos.
Yeah, it's preseason. And it is the Five Takes podcast. And we are back.
We're back, baby.
Like Michael Keaton as Batman.
Oh my God, I just about fucking died. I knew, apparently, I already knew. Like, Jenny was like, oh yeah, yeah, I told you. I'm like, the fuck you did? What are you talking about? Because I was like, I saw it. I was like, oh my God, babe. And I'm like, from the other, she's like in the kitchen. I'm like, oh my God, babe, get in here. Look. And she's like, what? And I was like, I can't back it up. What the fuck is happening? Because apparently on Hulu, I could not, because of the Super Bowl, because of the broadcast, because of, like, you know, copyright bullshit, I couldn't back up the broadcast. So she comes in, tail end, she's like, oh yeah, look, it's the bat. No, I was like, no, Michael Keaton.
Yeah.
And she's like, yeah, I knew.
I liked
she's
his, like,
I told you. I was like, no, but she
freaked his little smirky, his little snarky line. He's like, yeah, I'm Batman.
Like,
that's great.
Yeah.
Apologies to anyone listening to this with headphones. Kristen is very excited. Yeah, and your eardrums are probably blown out. I'll do my best,
yeah,
to adjust.
Sorry about that. Just adjust your stereos for a few minutes. But yeah, I'll just back up. I'll go
I'm genuinely excited for that. Basically,
which it's very interesting because I didn't think that Ezra Miller was allowed to act anymore.
DC just taking a cue from Marvel. It's basically the Flash, No Way Home.
That's exactly what it is.
They saw Spider-Man. They're like, guys, people really love nostalgia and bringing back characters that were beloved from older franchises. Who's got Michael Keaton's number?
Yeah.
Who can we call? Let's do that.
Let's see if this will work.
It genuinely looks good. I'm excited for it. I guess I see it.
Like I said, yeah, I didn't think Ezra Miller was allowed to act anymore with the way things have been going for him and like kind of the shitty things that he was doing out in the world. It was like, oh, okay.
I guess over the summer they tried to make him go to rehab and he actually said yes. I guess he's been going through a process. I don't know.
Well, that's okay. You know, I'm not one of those people that's like, oh, you can never redeem yourself, but I mean, he was being recast in things, you know, like what they did to Johnny Depp. So
it does sound like he was a bit of a USDA certified asshole. But there, I'm excited for it. Hopefully it's good.
I'm also a firm believer that you can be an asshole and not be intoxicated. Like, it is perfectly fine to just be a shitty fucking human being. You know, like, well, apparently if you're an actor. So that's what I'm saying. I'm like, oh, well, whether it was drug enhanced or alcohol or prescription drugs or whatever it was, it just sounded to me like he was just a prick. And it was like, nobody wants to work with you, dude. You're doing shitty things out in the world that nobody wants to be a part of it. No, you know, and it's true because it's like, you know, he's in Fantastic Beasts and everything like that. And nobody wanted to see it. They're like,
Yeah.
Well, that and J.K. Rowling being a complete transphobic twat. Nobody wants. I know we didn't go. I haven't seen the last two. I was like, no, I'm not. I want nothing. I want nothing to do with any of that.
Not so much because of that. More because I'm not a massive Potter nut. I'm not super.
Yeah. No, I hear you. But it's like, but what I'm saying is you're all you're doing is creating less and less reasons for me to go to the theater and go pay to watch somebody be a shithead. You know, like I happen to know certain things about other actors that I'm not going to talk about because I don't want to get fucking in huge trouble.
Give us the dirt.
No, I can't tell you who it is. But his name rhymes with Mince Mon. And he's just, I watched him get someone fired. And to me, as a comedic actor, and I saw it in person. I cannot watch anything with him in it because I can't get into it because I know how much of a shithead he is in real life.
Fair enough.
Not just from what I've read, but from what I physically fucking saw. I'm like, nah. And I'm here to report too. Most people, and this is what number one thing that I always get asked, I'm sure you do too, who's cool, who's not? Most people are very, very, very cool.
I will shout out. I mean, I had my best show that I did, Pain Hustlers, Netflix, this past fall, like a top three show in my 15-year career. Phenomenal experience.
Yeah.
Mostly British crew.
Right.
Who came from the Harry Potter side of things.
Sure.
Who just ran a great show. And they're all massive soccer heads. Most of them Arsenal fans, so whatever. But they were all very nice, which doesn't add up, but they were all very nice. Yeah. And I will say that Chris Evans and Emily Blunt were absolutely
totally delightful. Yeah, complete and people. Actual, like, real true humans, which is always super nice to find out about someone that they don't just exist in a plane, on a plane that doesn't exist for the rest of us.
Another person that shocked me that was a couple of years ago, Eve.
Of oh, sure.
Fame. Eve.
No, and I
who
and
knew
no, Eve,
who knew that Eve is a blue?
Yeah. No, I had no idea.
Years ago.
That's a good one.
Yeah, her that's husband a is an OG Chelsea. Like,
oh, see, there
so
you
that's
go.
How he came.
Interesting.
She came into it. And I gave Eve my scarf, and that was very cool.
Oh, that's cool. And I know I'm going to shout out. Who knows if he's ever going to listen to it? But I'm going to shout out to one of my favorite DPs that I've ever worked with.
DP is a director of photography, y'all.
That's right. Sorry. Yes, or otherwise known as a cinematographer. They don't always go hand in hand, but most of the time that they do. His name is Roger Chingarian. Huge
Roger.
Liverpool fan. We were talking red stuff all season long. We just wrapped. He's going to go back to LA for a little while, but he has a place here too. So hopefully I get to work with him again. It was really nice being able to talk shop every single week.
That was the same thing on Pain Hustlers.
We were struggling for a couple of weeks too. So I'd come in Monday morning, I'm going, Roger, are we ever going to score again?
My
Roger,
trouble
are we
was...
What's going on, man?
Almost my like trouble was on Pain Hustlers, I'd come in after the weekend or midweek match.
Yeah.
And, you know, I got the AD, I got the DP, I got camera people wanting to talk to me about matches. I'm like, guys, you cannot go down this rabbit hole with me. I have a job to do here. Focus. Yeah. I'm not even engaging them. They're coming to me. I'm like, we can't right now. Like, that's
but
it.
See, and the show is done. I had a completely opposite environment because when it was World Cup time, we were all watching World Cup. The camera guys being the camera guys, they were able to enlist the help from a couple of grips and hung a white sheet and used a tiny little mini projector that they had and projected the game at about a 5 foot by 5 foot, little mini projector screen, just off camera, you know, and I had my iPad on my cart over at our staging area where we keep all the lights ready to go into set. But it was great because you could see the different factions of people, you know, like you got these little people over here watching the game and these little people, especially during the group stages, it was like, oh, which game are you watching? Oh, I'm watching that. Oh, okay. Which game are you watching? So we had despite the fact that I was really concerned at the beginning when I started this show, because I was like, oh man, I don't have any soccer friends. It's like, that's not true at all. I had so many people.
So many.
Shout out to Pat King, my boy, Pat King. I got to work with him for like
Pat.
2 months. Oh man, that was so much fun having another like good soccer dude. Head. I mean, he knows about as much as you and I do. And so it was like, and he good played dude. In high school. It's like, oh man, I ended up having a really good soccer crew on this one. And now I'm like on the next one, I'm going to be like, oh man, Am I going to have anybody here? Or am I going to be all alone?
Yeah, I've peaked. Well, we're getting off the rails here a little bit. Like, apparently, every train in the country right now.
Oh, my God.
Just having some trouble staying on the tracks.
Spouting off absolutely deadly chemicals, though, into the atmosphere. Like, a friend of mine lives 100... She only lives an hour and a half away from there.
Oh, my goodness. And I'm like,
oh, my God.
East Palestine, Ohio. Gosh, I grew up near there.
She lives, you know, on the map. It's like this, you know? Yeah. You can
I know exactly where it's at.
Google Maps says an hour. She's an hour and a half south. So the good thing is that because she's an hour and a half southeast, the wind will literally blow the opposite, almost the complete opposite direction of where she's at. So it's like, oh, Jesus Christ.
Not good for your health. What is good for your health?
No,
it's chiropractic care.
Hey!
And we've got exciting news. So
that's a segue.
Sherwood is back with us again, and they have a new name. It is now Mason Mill Chiropractic. Same great care, same people. It's just that Dr. Sherwood has sold the business on to Dr. Cohen, and they are both still there. Mason Mill, that name comes from the area, old cotton mill that used to be there, the Mason Mill apartments and the parkway and everything else that's around there. So it is now Mason Mill Chiropractic. Everything is
good
the same.
Name, I think, you know, it's a really good, really good homage.
Great new logo.
You know, to the whole area, you know, where it kind of ties everything into the whole area. I think that's nice.
It's great. Great new logo, which you will see on great new shirts that we have coming soon from the fine folks at Olive and York, who do tremendous work, not only in terms of just their original, like, their design concepts. It's better than anything else that's out there.
Yeah, the really amazing.
And the work they're doing with small clubs, small organizations or podcasts like ours.
Yeah.
They're doing a lot to support the game at a grassroots level.
And the kits feel great, by the way. If we have any Footy Mob listeners out there, if you have any of the Footy Mob jerseys from the last several years, it's that same sort of really similar
feel. I think Footy Mobs for the most part were from Iron Tooth. I think
No. I'm just comparing. It's a very soft material, so it still feels like a regular kit, but at the same time it's breathable, but it still feels kind of soft. It's not just straight jersey.
It's great.
Feel.
You can wear it at work. You can wear it around the house. You can wear it and go work out. You can wear it and go run a half marathon like I did
today.
And the colors
always come through super vibrant. It's a really good quality material, and their website is super interactive, and it's super, like, you can pretty much it helps. It's just like any other kind of design website, but like you said, they're doing a really good job with
And they did great with us. I mean, the design team there was extremely patient with us. It was about a 2-week process. I submitted a bunch of designs. They took that and ran with it a little bit, came back with some other ideas, and we workshopped probably 12, 15 different looks for this shirt. And we always kind of kept coming back to, you know, and this happens in design, especially in logo design, the simplest form. Take away, take away, take away until it doesn't work. We had some more abstract options, some different things, but we always kind of kept coming back to this faded stripe look. It just looks classic, similar to the kit itself, and it's not overcomplicating it. I think they look great.
Yeah.
The logo will be, it's sublimation. It's not a patch, so it's nice. It's smooth. It's lightweight. They're very breathable. Mm-hmm. I wore an Olive and York kit today because I just got the notion to see if I could still run a half marathon today. And I just went out and did it and run around Stone Mountain and Snellville. And I can attest that it works. You know, it's wicking material, polyester. It's very, very comfortable. So we're excited for those. We're very excited to have Mason Mill with us again. And truthfully, further increasing their support of us, which is why we're able to get these shirts done. We might have some other things coming along as the season goes, some more stickers and what have you. So massive, massive thank you to them as always. And we have new people in the office there as well. Mindy has moved on. She is retired.
She's
living her best
happy.
She is living her best life in South Florida.
Mm-hmm.
And she's good. We're happy for her. We had a nice little going away party for her. So now we have Eva and Ashley in the office, and they're both outstanding. Same phone number, 404-321-0082. Call them. Exact same treatment. You're going to get treated the exact same way. You're going to feel like family when you go there.
That's right.
They'll tailor it to you. You'll be surprised at the level of just how personal it is, and how much they care, and how you start having genuine conversations with the doctors and the staff there. And they remember what's going on in your life. And I mean, you don't have to get that personal with them, but you can. And it's kind of nice when you're having, you know, physical adjustments done to you, because if you're dealing with something in your life that's stressful or you know, is time consuming, that can have an impact on your body. And it's nice to be able to share that with a doctor who actually cares and is taking that into consideration mm-hmm. when they're manipulating the bones in your body to get you right. So thank you again for them. We're really happy to have them back. We're really excited that we're able to do more this yep. year in terms yep.
really,
of the
really excited merch. to continue to move forward with everything yep. that we're doing.
Yep. It's going
to
be good.
I'm trying to convince Glenn, everyone out there, to eventually do a video podcast version of this. That may sure, be we'll get to on it. Yeah, that may be on the horizon.
I don't know who wants to see me, but sure, we could give it a go. Yeah.
No, but there's something about it that's we could offer it in two forms, and I think that there's something sure, about a yeah. visual element to it, you know, like people sitting in the office.
All the kids are doing it these something. Days. It's all the rage.
The young ones.
Everybody from Dirty South to the Cooligans, everybody's doing yeah. a video.
And I mean, everybody's got a damn computer these days with a camera on it. So it doesn't that's really, true. It's not, you know, is it all that interesting? I don't know. You can see how many hand gestures I do in a single podcast, which I can say spoiler is quite alert. A lot.
It's a lot. I'm doing
a lot right now. I'm literally using my hands to convey yes. how often I use
it's
my hands.
A lot of sign language.
It's, yes, it is. But it works for me, I want to say. And you'll see maybe even further how often we had to teach each other how to not cut each other off. And that's a big part of it is like
we can
visually see when the other person is trying to chime in and start with a new topic or a new idea or a new comment. So,
which I'm going to try to do now and get us going onto these dates.
I know. Eventually, 30 minutes in now, the 30 minutes that we've been recording, eventually we start talking about...
We're getting to the actual thing that our podcast is named after.
Oh, we're doing really well. Oh, but now, but it's been so boring up to this point.
And one last thing on the shirts. we will do some giveaways throughout the year. But if you also just would like one straight away, we'll sell them at cost. They're $30, probably $35 if we need to ship them to you.
Yeah.
We're not making we're a not profit
looking
off
to,
of
we're not these. We're not looking to make money. We're just want to get out there and spread the word.
Thank you to all of New York for keeping their prices so damn reasonable.
That's true. That's
Yo,
true.
Yo, the new kit, which I actually like, it's mm-hmm. fine.
Yeah, it's fine.
With customization,
$200. Yeah, it's insane.
I'll take my $30 olive in York, and you should too. Yes. All right, so number one here.
So let's talk about probably what I would consider to be the most promising, actually, yeah, preseason
the star of the
game
show.
Of the entire. No, I'm just saying. To me, it was the most promising and good, most good looking. Maybe it's because we were at home. Maybe we were taking it a little bit more seriously. But I don't know. It was the most promising preseason game.
Well, we're also
that we had
10 days away.
Well, I know. So that's what I'm saying is they're like, okay, let's take this almost as seriously as we will opening day for the first 45 guys. You take, you know, do your thing. And the second 45 guys, you're going to do your thing. And we're going to go out there and we're going to do it.
I had fun.
Yeah.
And I think Luis,
I enjoyed watching it.
Luis was the star of the show and has been the star of the preseason. He's shown a lot so far.
He looks
mm-hmm. different.
Yeah, very different. I don't know what it is.
You and I have talked about this a lot, that we all know he's got the skill sets. He's got the ability.
Yeah.
He just, at times, and those times being most of the times, unfortunately, hasn't made the best decisions.
Well,
Or trusted himself, or looked like he has. That seems to have been corrected. Look, the runs he's made off the ball thus far and with the ball at his feet Mm-hmm. And the finishes he's had. Some of these goals have been finesse.
That's like, true. Really, you know, weaving, nice, weaving just in and out of traffic, placement. Like just finishing and just and
you
just
see his
like,
goal last night, the run, the solo
yeah.
run.
Yeah, it was. That's what I'm saying. Weaving in and out, sticking with the ball, not giving up on the play until someone takes it off of his feet or it goes in the back of the net. I was actually really impressed by it.
More than just sticking with the ball, doing something with it. Like, sure. How many times have we seen him forward, try to make yeah. that run?
Yeah.
Skies it, yeah. loses it, what yeah. have you. This is the Luiz, this version. Yeah. This is what yeah. we've been waiting on.
I would say a good comparison to that is, in look, my opinion, is Barco, because Barco did sure. could do so much with yeah, the sure. ball at his feet that led to nothing all of the time. I'm like, wow, he's a really good dribbler. Into traffic and at the top of the box into six defenders that are just going to knock him over because he weighs 85 pounds and he's not going to do anything with the ball. So yeah. And then you take somebody like Luiz, who's quite a bit stockier and taller. And then he sees the defense hurtling towards him. So he decides to take a shot and shoots it 60 feet over the top of the freaking goal line. So it's, yeah, yeah. It was really good to see something continuously in the preseason coming from these shots that he's taking, because maybe, it can be so discouraging not to.
Maybe it's just taken him this long. Sometimes a player needs a year or two. I mean, how long did it take Miggy? He's balling out this year. 2-3 years.
That's true. That's well over.
And now he's vying for player of the year.
Yeah. God damn. He is.
If Luiz can.
It to Holland ice, they're gonna mm. who else is there?
Yeah, I know.
If
Luiz can
Saka, I don't know,
carry on, if he mm-hmm. can hit double digits this year, goals, and
I'd be very happy with that.
Give me 6-7 assists, mm-hmm. 12 goals, 6-7 assists.
Yeah,
a hell of a good season.
Yeah,
you know,
for a second year number, you know, newly appointed number third, 10, I'd be fine year. With that. Oh, is it third?
Second
oh,
and a half.
Silly me. Well, that's true. That's true. So I would say, yeah, I'd be real happy with that, yeah, especially for it. And not only that, you can assist without it leading to a goal. You can be productive, obviously. Yeah,
be productive with your touches.
Super, yeah, like do passes. Have it make sense. Mm-hmm.
Your involvement yeah. needs to be more productive,
just positive too,
and not, you know, just, you know, individual, oh, that was a nice little skill check move.
Yeah,
what did it lead to?
Led
oftentimes
to
nothing. Right.
Yeah,
just carry on with what he's doing. Mm-hmm. And I think he'll be all right.
Ow.
I mean, it's preseason. What?
Ow.
Why ow?
Wow, I just had a thing. Nothing, everything's fine. Moving on.
Yeah, no, the video is a great idea. All right, so defensively, we've had problems in the preseason.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of hard for me to be concerned about that right now. Look, there's lots of miscommunication. There was last night, or no yep. communication at all. Brad's not between the sticks, barking out yep. the orders. Yep. He was in Chattanooga, but that's our first preseason game. So
it was a very. You know. I like how you quoted it. By the way, it's a very mullety defense.
Pretty much.
Mullety team, if that, you know.
I think we can also expect that in the regular season, when it counts, no disrespect to AmFam, but when it counts, that some of those spaces that we saw last night that yeah. weren't closed down probably would be,
yeah.
and players are going to get stuck in a yeah. bit more than they were. I'm happy that, well, Chol apparently did his hammy. But it was the first goal last night was to not get hurt, but unfortunately we did.
Yeah.
Even though Caleb appears to be okay after that nasty knock he took to the head. But
yeah.
I'm not overly concerned, because I haven't seen really the back line that's gonna be starting. And right. for what it's worth, we're really not gonna see our first choice midfield either for a couple right. of games, because Sosa's gonna be out on suspension. For the first 2-3 games, carrying over from the end of last season, so yeah, he won't be there.
But the thing is that we know the quality of those players that were absent in the preseason. So I'm not really worried about that. Yeah, you take a look at the last two goals that Toluca scored, and those were just
also
chalk it up to even amateur mistakes, to be honest. Like, one amateur, of them was like, what are you doing with that?
In the second half, we were playing our amateur player. No disrespect. The kids actually did really well. I'll talk about them later.
They did fine.
They're playing their first team.
Yeah. Yeah. I know. Not a whole lot of that seemed really fair.
I get it. When AmFam is on the line, throw everything at it. Throw the kitchen sink at it. That parade they're going to throw. Be big.
See, if we have video, I don't have to describe when I do air quotes. But yeah, it was not a necessary thing for us to go full bore, and I'm glad that they didn't. I am. I'm glad that they didn't. But it's like, so they're going to take back the AmFam Cup. Nope, they don't even know what that is. They don't care. You know, we don't care. It's silly. It's the preseason game. No one cares.
Does American Family Insurance operate in Mexico? I don't know. All right. So
I'm guessing no.
Like, summing up the defensive stuff, I mean, I'm not super concerned about it right now, because I would expect the goals we've conceded thus far and the way that we've conceded won't happen in that way in the regular season with those same players.
Right. And look, we'll still
concede. We can still get scored on in the regular season, and we will. We could still have defensive problems. That could happen. But I don't think the preseason matches that we've played thus far are indicative of that problem. That problem could be there.
It's not going to look like this.
I'm not looking at these going, there's something to take away. No. So then in the regular season, when we struggle, I still wouldn't be able to go back at the preseason and go, see, look at all. It's not the same. Especially with Miles not being back there, so on and so forth.
No, I take any, everybody's like, oh man, we're doing so bad. I'm like, what are you comparing it to? Yeah. You know, like, what? It's not even.
Yeah.
They played 45 minutes. Here's the thing. It was 2-2 going into the half, right?
Mm-hmm.
Let's
be happy that we're putting it in the back of the net, huh?
That was my big note to you. That was my take. Hey, they had their pro players on the full 90. Yes, they substituted a lot, but you're allowed to. It's because nobody cares. But what I'm saying is that they didn't send out their amateur. They didn't send out their farm league, right, again, air quotes, you know, as it is that we have, that we sent out in the second 45. Of course they're going to score two more, because it's practically like they're playing an entirely new team that is, I don't like the word amateur. I don't think, you know, semi-pro. You know what I'm saying?
Kids.
You know, those guys are still learning. They're still young. And hey, they still scored on them. They still scored. Young.
I know. Like, young. I'm going to jump to number five. I'll come back to three and four, even though three, not basically much more to talk about that.
Yeah.
Toll getting hurt. No disrespect to him, but if someone's going to get hurt,
he's not going to play for the first team.
Well, as long as we avoid injuries this season, he shouldn't see a ton of minutes.
Yeah.
And for me, I'm not really sure what Pineda's seeing in him as wanting to go, looking at him going, wonder how he'd do it as a striker.
Yeah, it's not like with, like, really Mascara, like when we had Mascara, because I really liked him, because it's like you could bring him in as like a 75th minute sub.
But Chol,
and
all he nine?
Is speed. Chol, what does Chol do?
Wing, like the nine, I just...
Yeah, he was like, a left-winging
I don't
nine.
Know
it was
what
weird.
That was. And Caleb's okay, so I think we're okay there. But on to the kids. Johnny Fortune, I've watched a lot of him with the twos. This kid is dripping.
Saw him a
talent.
Lot. Really liked him. And I was sad to hear that we lost Robbie Mertz. That's another guy that I really thought we didn't lose him. I mean,
he went home. He went back up to
Pennsylvania.
Yeah, he
went back to Philadelphia. But I really, he, being able to watch the twos, you know, I don't get to go as much as I'd like to, because it's usually in the middle of the week. You know, it's on Wednesdays.
And it's hard
like
to
that.
Get up to fifth third.
And it's hard to get all the way up there. Yeah, it is. So at least from our side of town, because we live on the west side of Atlanta, and it's on the
it's
north side.
It's still hard from Stone Mountain.
Northeast
it's a drive.
Side of, it's a drive. Of Atlanta. So it's, but going there and being able to observe these guys at the semi-pro level and really seeing them in sort of their element, Johnny Fortune is one that I'm like, yeah, that guy's
him and we're Luke Brennan. See him.
Yeah, and Luke Brennan's been was great yesterday. Had he's the 17 years old.
Hockey assist. Holy crap. Mm-hmm. Pretty confident out there. And like you said, these kids are going up against mm-hmm. pros. And they put one in.
Are so lucky to to have an academy and the under 20s and everything that we have.
We've done it well.
We've done a really good job. And I'm not that many other teams, not a lot of other teams have that.
We've had our struggles big time. The mm-hmm. past few seasons have not been good in terms of the results with the first team. Academy continues to do pretty well. The twos, look, if you're going to watch the twos and expecting them to be top of the table, they're always going to be kind of near the bottom or mid because it's not about winning with them. It's about,
it's about
developing players.
Fitness.
You know, sending up the next homegrown. That's what it's about. And speaking of another homegrown, we had a mini Frosted Orange out there. Andrew Carlton's little brother.
I couldn't believe that. I honestly was like, wait a minute. Is that... It is, isn't it? What the hell?
Yeah.
I'm like, how did I not know that? And then I was like, wait a minute. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I'm like, they even freaking look alike. And I was like,
yeah, they look exactly the same.
What is going on? Are we just... picking him out now? Like, I don't know. And that's fine. You know, he didn't do badly. He did fine.
He was fine.
You know, if he wants to go play for the twos, great.
If he continues to develop and stay away from insurrections, I think he should be fine.
He brings his passport when necessary.
That would also be helpful. All right.
Oh, my God.
Enough shade at the Carlton's.
No, I don't know if it is. I don't know. We'll come back to it. If we ever see him again, I'll make sure to mention it.
Sure, we'll watch him out. Watch for him on the twos. So with Chol, when he got hurt, wrapping up here with number four. Sure, we'll just go wrap up with number four. This is a bummer for me.
It
gave Jackson the opportunity to come on. I have some big hopes for him this year because he's never.
I don't know why.
He's had his moments, right? Had it with Heinze. He had that goal in Nashville. It was great. But he's never really been able to stake his claim.
But you
with the first
you just
team,
said it.
But with Joseph gone, he really could see some minutes.
Yeah, but that
behind our new DP, behind
Yako,
he could.
But we faced that as a potential before, and it didn't work
out. I know.
Then either.
That's what I'm saying. He did have a pretty good year with the twos last year, despite the twos being as they typically
bottom,
are,
like you
pretty
said,
much near the rock bottom of the table. But he scored a bunch of goals, good goals. He really did.
Good.
But he just once again, so far in preseason, hasn't shown much. And I really love the interview that he did with Doug Roberson from the AJC, talking about he didn't take a vacation after this season ended. He didn't go anywhere. He stayed and maxed out the Planet Fitness membership and was just hitting it every day, bulking up out on the training pitch. Trainers stayed behind to work with him at the training grounds, putting in the work. Saying, you know what? I got to get serious, right? This could be my year. This has to be my year. I'm going to make this happen for myself. And then he also talked about his new haircut. demonstrating his level of seriousness. You know, when you're going high and tight, you're got that footballer haircut. But unfortunately, and it's just preseason. Someone could not do well in preseason and then ball out or vice versa. It's just preseason. So I'm going to go ahead and read too much into this.
Totally. Read just, all you want.
He just hasn't shown much. He is a big boy.
Well,
he is
a big boy.
And
see,
he does not use his strength and size to his advantage.
He had a golden opportunity
at the end. And
so
he
what
didn't
did we do?
Take it.
Right.
He didn't take it.
So what did we do when we didn't have an optional striker when Joseph was down? We had to go with him because he's the only one we had. And he didn't show it then because
not consistently.
He didn't have it then. I don't know if he's got it now. The problem is he is, to me, a 75 minute sub
to give
our center forward a rest when we're up three goals to none.
What is it then? Because he hit double digits with the twos. Is it just the level? Is that it?
Yeah.
He can't keep up with this level? It's too much for him?
That's what I think. Mm-hmm.
He's scoring on easy opposition?
I don't think it's easy opposition. I think it's a different style of play. The goals he scored weren't,
for the most part, tap-ins.
I think it's a different style of play. I don't know. But they were similar to his opportunity he had last night.
I don't think that's it either. They're similar.
Is that the same ball? Is that the same ball that he's been getting at the twos?
Similar.
Really?
Yeah, is it similar? Though? A lot of his goals have been, you know, just muscling a guy out in the box and owning
smaller,
it, going up for it.
Smaller, younger guys, though? You know, at the semi-pro level? I don't know.
Not really.
We'll see.
I say all this, and I don't know what it is. Right. I don't have the answer for why he can do so well at the lower level, other than it's just a lower level, and he's just a half step above that, but can't compete at the very top. Right.
I hope I'm wrong,
you know, we don't know if Yako's visa is going to come through quickly, when he'll be able to start. Jackson might be seeing some minutes here, and I would love for nothing more than for us to be talking about, okay, it took him 2-3 years. Boy, worth the wait. I would love that.
We'll see. My position on Conway has been, I just don't see a place for him other than, like I said, a 75th or an 80th minute sub to give our center forward a rest while we're up three goals to none.
I don't even think Gonzo has seen much in training or in preseason. I mean,
no,
look, he's starting Machop Chol up there.
Well, of course, yeah.
But that's, you know what I mean?
That's what I'm saying. There isn't really a place for him.
Man.
Well, it's too bad.
That one's frustrating. He had me fooled with that really great interview he gave. He said all the right things and that how much work he's put in the offseason. He probably has.
Right.
But if it's still not coming good, I don't know where his mindset is. If he still feels like, if he's angry at like, well, why is Chol starting? Why am I not? Like,
well, mindset is all well and good.
We don't see the training every day, but something isn't clicking. Something isn't being shown.
I believe you, but you got to put the ball in the back of the net. It's going to be the way to win people over.
And he should have last night. He should have scored, and we should have gone to penalties.
He should have done better. That header was perfect.
He should have scored.
He had a little bit of contact.
Should have scored.
He couldn't even get his head on it. He didn't even touch it.
That's a goal. Mm-mm. That's a goal for him and his size. That's a goal. And we go to penalties. And we defend our title. And now we are dishonored. No AmFam.
Jackson. No silverware so far.
Well, that was surprisingly long for a friendly.
there was a good 10 minute for about 20 minutes, but
yeah, there was a good 10-20 minute digression on Batman.
So you got to I don't call it a digression. I call it a progression. Thank you very much. Anyway, so yeah, you take a good 20 minutes away off the top, and it's a good 30 minute podcast on a friendly.
We're right on time.
Doing good.
All right, y'all. Well, thank you for listening to us for yet another season. And thank you for going to Mason Mill, formerly Sherwood, now Mason Mill. If you're continuing to go there, thank you very much. If you are new and going there, thank you very much. And it would help us out a lot if you are going there for the first time to just, you know, casually mention that you heard about it from us.
Yeah, let them know you heard about it on the Five Takes.
Oh,
Nothing wrong with that.
They will have, when the shirts arrive, which should be in a couple weeks.
Yep.
They will have them for sale there as well. Mm-hmm. So multiple places. You can always hit us up on socials, email.
Yep.
Five Takes on the Five Stripes at gmail.com, on Twitter, the same, Facebook, what have you. Or just at Sherwood, or, you know, if you see me walking around with a Five Take shirt on, or Kristen walking around with a Five Take shirt on, let us know. And like I said, we'll do some giveaways as well. But if you'd like one straight away, $30 or 35 if you're an out-of-towner and you would like to have
And no flash photography, please. We scare easily. So just come up to us and talk to us and ask us if you want to, if you want to know which one of us you've happened to run into as a crazy celebrity sighting. I don't go to malls anymore, so I don't know where you're going to see me. But you never know. I could pop up anywhere.
There's a lot of hand gestures here, y'all. All right. Thank you very much for listening. Jazz we hands. Will be back next week. We get to play San Jose, which hasn't Yay. Happened for a minute. And that'll be wild because it's always wild with San Jose. You don't know how to play
the OGs. The OGs listening will remember and what we mean by that. And it,
they
it's
don't
always
know.
Interesting. It's
they
always,
don't know how to play a normal game.
No, ever. So yeah, you never know.
Even
maybe,
with
maybe Conway
even with
scores
a, not being their coach anymore, even with him being gone, they're still going to be crazy.
Maybe Conway scores a hat trick. It could get crazy. It could get crazy.
It would be amazing if that happened. All right, we will be back next week. Until then, y'all be good. We will be back.
Meow.